Graduated from Edison in 2006. I started pole vaulting. Brendan just said, I think you should give pole vault a shot. I think you'd like it and have a lot of fun. So when I came to Edison my freshman year, I just started right away. I have to say, when the idea like really first popped in my head, I knew I had like some success right off the bat, and my high school coach, Nate Fox, was really positive and letting me know that I had the ability to do something great with pole vault, but I don't know if it really sunk into my head at that point. I think maybe in college, once I started to see a bit more success, my senior year was like the first time that I actually thought like, oh, this might be something that's a realistic goal finally. So probably in college, then I graduated and continued to train towards it. I went to UCLA, graduated 2010. So because I compete for Ireland, we have a little bit of a different process. I obtained Irish citizenship through my grandmother. So number one, I'm on the Irish team, and then the way we qualify on our team is to hit the Olympic A standard. So it's set by the Olympic Committee. You have to jump a certain height to actually get into the Olympics, which is in meters, it's 450, which in feet and inches is 14 feet 9 inches. So basically, I had to hit that mark within a certain time frame leading up to the Olympic Games. All sorts of training. I guess pole vault workouts can be described, you know, you have to be quick, so there's some sprinting workouts. A lot of weightlifting because you need to be strong. We spend some time in the gymnastics room because there is that like body awareness element. And then actual pole vaulting, just kind of mixed in with other track workouts and plyos, things like that. Let's see, for a meet day, I always double check that I have my spikes and my chalk because I definitely need chalk on my hands to vault. And then I usually pack like a couple of water bottles and maybe like a protein drink for after. Some snacks, maybe like a sandwich and a banana or an apple. And like a yoga mat to sit on. I basically like set up camp because you're gonna be there for a couple hours. Just walking out onto the stadium for the first time, it was just like a roar that I've never heard before, you know, 80,000 people in the crowd. I think the biggest advice is to believe in yourself. I think if there was anything that I was lacking, even though I knew I was like a decent pole vaulter and had some talent, I just think I always set my goals a little bit too short. It was like, oh, I'll be a good pole vaulter and maybe I'll get a scholarship to college, but I don't know about the Olympics. Like, those are for the really good athletes. I think if you really believe in something and really have a passion for something, you should just go for it and totally follow your dream, as cliche as that sounds.